city of Moulton, crime is at an all-time high, with murder, robbery and corruption ruling the streets. With the public demanding results in an end to crime, a task force was created to combat these vile criminal elements as they continue to plague the city. The squad was responsible for capturing the city's most wanted criminals, and we always got our man. The public called us the Crime Busters. The squad was led by me, Lieutenant Jim Reed, though most people call me Noir Reed. And in this story of the Noir Files, we continue where we left off. Even though the Crime Busters have been disbanded, most of us, of the remaining Crime Busters, have come back together to take back our city from the Duke. And our first step is to take down his top enforcer and hitman, a wrestler who wants to prove to everyone around him that he is the toughest man in the city of Moulton. The man's name is Alejandro Monasterio, also known as El Dorado. Alejandro was born in a section of Moulton City dominated by Mexican, Latino, and Spanish immigrants. As a kid, he had shown a passion for sports and was particularly good at wrestling. But he had very little interest in pursuing any academic careers in school. Eventually, at the age of 16, he dropped out of high school and began doing some odd jobs to get by. But the money just always kept coming up short. With little patience, he eventually began to do some hold-ups and robberies for the local Latino cartel, which gave him the thrill and excitement, but what he really wanted was to be a wrestler. But he could not get it done the legitimate way. Now, one day, he had heard about an underground fight club where the best of the best fighters fought for large sums of money. And with all the city's biggest crime lords were all there to watch and possibly recruit new enforcers, well, he was very brash and very desperate for cash, so he came to the club one night and signed up to fight. He then had his first shot of being a wrestler. He had won his first fight, and as a result, he would continue to keep winning more. Eventually, he took on the stage name of El Dorado. As to the origins of where he got the name, well, that still remains unclear. Eventually, one day, he met and befriended a rising mobster in the criminal underworld. That man was the Duke. As a result, he began to work as his top enforcer. As, honestly, the Duke was a fan of his wrestling career and thought he'd be a good asset to his gang. He then was tasked to do a special hit for him, which he succeeded not only to pay cash, but he would get the excitement of being part of the criminal underworld and hopefully gain some well-needed respect. The hit in question was on a top cartel earner. Now, he was given a location and was sent to do the deed. El Dorado went to a local Mexican restaurant where the man in question was there. El Dorado just simply walked in and started beating the guy up.
Don't do it! My arm! was that, huh? Got anything else to say?
The guy was practically beaten to death, and the Duke was very impressed with his abilities, and became his go-to hitman and enforcer. His name was then linked to numerous murders, but we couldn't prove it. El Dorado was considered to be the toughest man in the city, with numerous body counts to his name. He still would hold on to his boxing matches, and he would essentially challenge newcomers, but they would usually lose. He then became prominent in both the protection rackets and even his own wrestling matches with a special prize for those who would win. Of course, again, no one ever won. He became arguably one of the most feared men in Molten City's underworld. Now that his origin and rise to prominence is out of the way, let's get to the rest of the story. Now by this point, me, Brett, Abby, Olivia, Peter, and Axel were working from our base, which was pretty much my local neighborhood bar, and were waging war with the Duke. We were destroying all his operations with the loan sharking and protection rackets, mostly protection rackets, in which El Dorado was the boss of. Now, we tried to get Leroy to join us, but he felt that he was better at the training academy to the recruits to become better cops, and did not want them to end up like, well, Malone. Eventually, we managed to get word of a possible shakedown of a small local business, so me and Axel went there to arrive and look at the local disturbance. It turns out it was a trap. El Dorado was there along with his top guys, and we ended up in a shooting match. I ended up getting knocked out and taken away, but Axel was left for dead. I then woke up and found myself tied to a chair, where I came face to face with the Duke. He then tried to see if he could bribe me, but then a familiar voice came forward, said that I couldn't be bought. It was Malone. He said that he was honest as they come. Eventually, the Duke agreed with him and ordered me to be killed. And just when I thought that my time had come, an explosion went off. During the confusion, I managed to get free and found myself in an old wrestling ring with El Dorado there, and he demanded a fight with me to see who was the better fighter. You see, even though El Dorado liked to consider himself the best fighter, the toughest man in the city, for a while there was a rumor circulating that I was actually the toughest man in Molten City, and El Dorado had a massive ego, and he could not allow someone to challenge that title, so he demanded me to have a one-on-one fight, to finally find out who was truly the toughest. And well, I obliged him. After all, I needed a rematch when he defeated me at the local shop business where he ended up capturing me. We agreed to fists only and a fair fight. And, well, seconds out. In the end, I came out on top, but the Duke and Malone were gone. I ended up calling Tara Joan, and she came down there and reported the whole ordeal on live television. This caused a chain reaction of citizens who began to stand up to the people, shaking them down, and eventually lead to El Dorado being arrested. But who caused that explosion? We will have to wait for maybe another time to find the answer to that. The incident did, however, end up having Leroy end up leaving the training academy and coming to help us in the fight with the Duke. He also ended up bringing two recruits along. The recruits were Ling Su and Gotti DeVito, who also wanted to help and felt they could do it best by joining Leroy in this ragtag team than the training academy. Now, El Dorado was given 5 years. He would have served longer, but the Duke had people in high places grease it so he wouldn't be in prison as long. And just when we're about to make plans to further go after the Duke, Ziva was arrested. Her bail was revoked and she was about to be put on trial for her role in being corrupted, and was about to go up against what the underworld called the Alibi Lawyer. You want to know more about that? Then join us next time. But for now, another criminal is locked up, and I, Noir Reed, call this case closed. Join us next time as we tackle another criminal in the Noir Files. See you then.